Hello, welcome back to this video lesson. In this particular lecture, I'm going to discuss about how to find center of mass of few dimensional bodies such as ring, semicircular ring, semicircular disc, and few more geometry. So first of all, semicircular ring. Semicircular ring, right? So for a semicircular ring, considering it is to be of uniform mass distribution, it is of uniform mass distribution. Okay. Now, according to the basic principle of finding center of mass of any dimensional body, what I am going to do first of all, I am going to select one set of two mutually perpendicular line as the reference axis. So two such lines are, one is x-axis, another one is y-axis. So this is the x-axis line, this is y-axis line, okay, and I can place the half ring on this xy plane. But in generally most of the cases, we used to consider the dimensional body probably in the first quadrant, but here we won't try the same. We will try it little bit of different than comparing to the other cases. Why? I am going to explain you why. Let this is be the y-axis, and now if I select a semicircular ring like this, if I place a semicircular ring like this, such that half of the semicircular ring appearing in first quadrant and half of the semicircular ring is appearing on second quadrant, such that this y-axis becomes the axis of symmetry. Y-axis becomes axis of symmetry for this semicircular ring. Okay. Now, for example, the semicircular ring having, to understand the dimension, I mean, like I am drawing another line, but that does not mean I am going to consider the thickness. This is the semicircular ring. So its dimension is something like that. For example, its radius is R. This is the center of the ring. If I name it O, let ABC, that is the half ring, semicircular ring. Being it is uniform, so that means mass per unit length is constant. I can say mass per unit length is constant, right? So let that mass per unit length is considered to be the term lambda, that is m by l. Being it is half circle, semicircle, so its length will be pi r. R is given the radius of the semicircular ring, so its length will be pi r, half ring. Now, to get the center of mass of this semicircular ring, what I can do, I can select two such identical elements on either side of the ring. These are two identical elements, both are supposed of length dl, such that this dl segment is concerned, that is, for example, subtending angle d theta each at the center of the half ring. At the center of the half ring, we are taking two identical elements, right? We are taking two identical elements on either side of the y-axis, which is here the axis of symmetry for this semicircular ring. So geometry wise, using the coordinate geometry, I can say if this is d theta, this is theta, for example, so geometrically this will also be theta, okay, as I am saying that they are identical elements, then being this point taken as origin, the general point of this segment is assumed to be x comma y, then corresponding this will be minus x comma y. So y coordinate for both these two identical elements are same. Both are above the x-axis, so their y position is positive. But so far as x is concerned, one element is appearing to the left of the y-axis, means its x is negative, whereas the other element is to the right side of y-axis, is having its x positive. So ultimately I can say for one pair of identical as well as symmetrical element, as well as symmetric elements, which is shown here in the diagram, I have chosen in the diagram, you can see that I have chosen two elements on either side of the y-axis. They are equidistant from y-axis at equal geometrical position. So I can say these two pair are just not only identical by length, they are placed in such a way so that one can be symmetric to the other. I mean, like one can be the mirror image of the other about y-axis, right? So that's why they are symmetric pair. So whatever the x distance is for this one, the same x distance but negative will be for the other element. So for one such pair of identical as well as symmetric elements, the corresponding xcm for just these two pair is concerned, can I write down dm into plus x plus dm into minus x divided by 2 dm? We know that for n number of point objects, to get their x coordinate of center of mass, we used to consider x distances of all those individual point object forming that system, and in numerator we sum up the product value of mass and respective distances of those point objects from y-axis. So similarly, for these two elements, mass of this element into plus x plus mass of this element into minus x divided by their mass, so isn't it zero? So for one such pair of identical and symmetric pair of elements, if the x coordinate of the center of mass for one such pair is coming zero, so according to the diagram, the total mass of the half ring can be expressed as the combination of infinite number of symmetric pair of elements. Like this is one pair of symmetry, at some different theta we can again get another pair of symmetry. So for each and every possible value of theta, we can get one such pair of symmetric elements. So if we assume that there are total 100 elements, just for an example, there are total 100 elements from A to C, then there can be 50 pair of symmetric elements. So each pair of symmetric elements will have their xcm 0. So 0 will be the position of xcm for each and every symmetric pair. So ultimately this implies that xcm of all the pairs of symmetric elements, will be zero, means the overall center of mass of this semicircular ring will lie on the y-axis. Is that okay? Will lie on the y-axis. So that means we should calculate YCM on behalf of this semicircular ring. We should calculate YCM on behalf of this semicircular ring. Are you getting me? Because even for one pair of symmetric elements, their y distances will not be opposite, rather both will be positive. In fact, y distance for all the elements throughout the half ring will be positive, so there will be no option of getting cancelled out. So that's why we can calculate YCM of the system. So to calculate YCM of the system, we will do it like that. It is integration of dm into, that is this element into its corresponding y distance, divided by integration of dm. Okay, for numerator, if I add up all elements in 1/2 and multiply it with 2, so I will get the result including the other half of the semicircular ring as well. Question arises, why I am doing so? Because you can see there are two elements I have taken. Order of theta, if I take 0 to 90 for this half of the elements, I will move anticlockwise according to the geometrical position. But again, to move for theta 0 to 90, for other half I will have to move opposite in order. Integration is advised for continuous function, right? So if I want to integrate all the elements from one end to the other end of the semicircular ring, then I should take theta continuously in one order from one end element to the other end elements. But according to this geometrical position that I have taken and the term that I have expressed, so theta will be going opposite in order for the elements from either of the end at A and C. So that's why whatever the result I will get by integrating 1/2 of the half ring, the same result we'll get for the other half also. So that's why, because for one value of y we will get two elements, at one specific y we will get two elements. So that's why all the values of y in 1/2 into 2 will include the other half also. And when I will integrate dm, so I will talk about the total mass. So in numerator part, 2 into integration of dm. Dm means mass of this element, mass of element, that is equal to dm. So that can be written lambda into dl. Lambda is the mass per unit length, that into length of the element will be considered as the mass of element. So lambda into dl, that into y, divided by integrating the total mass, let it be m. I'm simply instead of doing the integration against the term expression in denominator, I'm simply writing the final result, because I know when I will integrate, that means when I'll add all the values of dm, I will finally get the value of total mass m only. So well, 2 lambda by m, constant term, let it be taken out. So variable is ydl. So question is, this can't be integrated. We can't integrate this ydl for y, because if y is the variable, then while doing the integration we must have the element of the variable. That means y should be available with dy for integration. So if it is not dy, then how can I integrate it with element dl? So variable and its corresponding element cannot be two different terms. So what I'll do, see, from geometry was something like this. This was theta, this is r, this is y. So in term of theta, can I write down y is equal to r sine theta? And being this is dl, subtending d theta as an angle, so dl can also be replaced as r d theta. Are you getting me? Arc length is equal to radius into angle subtended. So overall, so this implies that the YCM calculation now turns to be 2 lambda by m into integration of lambda I have taken out, y. Instead of y I can write down r sine theta, and for dl I can write down r d theta. So now in terms of theta, the theta that will vary from 0 to pi by 2 for half of this ring, that is in one side between B and C or between A and B. Okay. So further, r and r, r square, that can be taken out. So I can write down 2 lambda r square by m into integration of sin theta d theta for limit 0 to pi by 2. We know that integration of sin theta is how much? Minus cos theta. So I can write down that integration result 2 lambda r square by m, it is minus cos theta for its limit 0 to pi by 2. Okay, putting the upper limit value of theta, it will be minus cos pi by 2, that is 0, minus of minus cos 0, that is 1. So ultimately it will be 2 lambda r square by m into 1. The overall result of the integration will become 1 only. Are you getting me or not? So this is the term which we are getting as the YCM calculation involving the lambda, that is mass per unit length. If we want to use the proper mass expression, then this YCM calculation, can be simplified 2 r square by m, instead of lambda I can write down m by pi r. So here m gets cancelled out, 1 r gets cancelled out, so it is 2 r by pi. Yes, so this is that YCM position, YCM calculation against the semicircular ring. Are you getting me? Against the semicircular ring, YCM calculation will be 2 r by pi, that is 2 by pi times radius. So from where we are measuring this distance, from the center of the circular geometry, which is origin of the coordinate axis here. So that means center of mass can be somewhere here. It is on the line of symmetry, that is y axis, such that this distance is equal to 2 by pi times r. So that means ultimately we come to know that center of mass of a semicircular ring will always appear on the line of symmetry, the line which will divide the half ring in two equal portion, and that too at a distance 2 by pi times the radius from the center along the line of symmetry. Is that okay?